So let's look at something more complicated for more advanced English speakers. So let's select some problem which uses a lot of words. So it's number 7. So we have two villages. Village deal. A and B. There are 100 students, high school students in A, and only 50 students in B. And the question is, so the distance is 3 kilometers. And the villagers want to construct a school. So there is a school somewhere between A and B. And the idea is to optimize the position of the school. Мы хотим построить здесь две деревни А и Б. Здесь 100 школьников, здесь 50. Мы хотим построить школу. Нужно расположить ее наилучшим образом. The best possible position. Наилучшим образом в том смысле, чтобы суммарное расстояние, проходимое всеми школьниками, было как можно меньше. То есть мы считаем, сколько школьников, каждый школьник прошел, складываем. We want to make the total distance for all the students minimal. Minimal. So there are 100 students going from A to the school, and 50 students going from B to the school, and each of them makes some distance. Каждый из них проходит какое-то расстояние. We add all these distances, and then we try to minimize, сделать наименьшее. The total distance. Total, тотальная вся, общая. Total distance.
Сумма расстояний.
Сумма всех расстояний. Суммарное расстояние, общее расстояние. The sum of all distances for each of the students. And the question is where the school should be located. So it's difficult English thing, so it's for you. Please come and explain. But be not too fast, otherwise we will not understand you.
Logically, the school should be in the middle because so both can go, like both students from both schools can go.
But yeah, it's quite strange to construct it somewhere here, yes. Because it will create why not to move it here?
Yes.
It's worse for both for me. But so где школу разумно построить где-то между А и Б? Yeah.
But here are 100 students and here are only 50. So
yeah.
If we move like a kilometer from here, it's less 100x of the distance. And here is more 50, so it's more less distance if we put it in A.
Okay, so you, of course you are right, but you are quite short. So do I understand the explanation? Or can you repeat the explanation just to be sure that we're clear? I have no doubt you understand the solution. The problem is.
Нет, я как раз сомневаюсь в решении. А вот давайте решение прозвучит по-русски хотя.
Okay, maybe. Okay, just translate the solution. So for the answer, it should be constructed in A. If I will construct, let me translate you word by word. If I construct the school in the middle, just exactly in the middle between A and B.
То тогда тут
стоит,
где моя школьника А будет в два раза больше проходимого от Б.
Yeah, then each of the students will go the equal distance, but there are twice more students.
Yes.
Двое больше, twice more students. So the total distance for A students will be twice bigger than the total distance for B students.
Если я на какое-то расстояние школу сделаю.
Let's imagine that we make some change. So it was in the middle, and we made some change by some, I don't know, we can denote it by something, by some x. just somebody comes and suggests to move the school closer to X. Кто-то предлагает изменить положение школы и сдвинуть ее на X. How it will affect, как это повлияет на расстояние? How it will affect the distances to A and to B? 50
students from each. Yeah.
Each of them have to go additional length x. So b increases 50x.
Увеличится.
Yeah.
Увеличится, increases the distance for b, increases by 50x. Увеличится на 50x.
Расстояние
для него
школьниками от а, потому что их 100. Два расстояния меньше.
And for A students, new position is better, новое положение лучше, each of them goes x less,
меньше.
Движется на x меньше.
Да.
So they have some improvement, они, их положение улучшается. Если what is this improvement?
Два раза.
Нет,
два раза.
На каждого человека, если я взял одно, стоит отсюда, в два раза больше, поэтому...
Коля, там был...
Each of them will go x less, and in total, всего вместе...
Будет в два раза меньше, чем...
So the improvement is twice bigger than the loss in the first time.
Yes.
So, the same distance is increased here, is added here, and subtracted here. But here we have twice more students, and so the advantage is bigger than disadvantage.
Yeah.
So what is the conclusion? Какое заключение?
Школа стоит деревня.
So the bigger x is, the better is for us. Чем больше x, тем для нас лучше. Увеличение x увеличивает выгоду. Пока мы не дойдем до A. When we are in A, if we go here, then it starts, it's lost for everybody. Это всем плохо.
Да.
So our answer is that we put our school in A.
Да.
Okay. So everybody, I hope everybody understand the solution. Okay, and who is brave enough to try to summarize or repeat it shortly in English? Let's try. Just, I want to see. You know, everybody speaks. Just to try.
If we go to the school in the middle, then...
Or just somewhere, in any place.
Okay.
And then move it.
Yes, if we move it... to this place, then it will be much better for students.
It's better for students in A, but it's worse for students in B.
Yes. So if we want to make...
But the question is the trade-off. Кто, что больше? So why it's better to move it to the left?
Because 100 students will walk 100 kilometers. 1 kilometer each, and
if we move by 1 kilometer,
yes,
then 100 students move in from A. Just each of them moves actually 2 kilometers if they go back and forth. But okay, but if we just go in one direction, it's 1 kilometer advantage.
And each student from the
from B
will go for 2 kilometers.
So what?
From students from A walk 100 kilometers, and students from B will walk also 100.
Okay, so why then we move it to A?
Because in A there are much more students than in B, so that the total distance will be less.
But we always spoke about 100 students and 100 kilometers. So you say that it's 100 kilometers for A and 100 kilometers for B. Why still we have advantage?
Because the total distance will have the less total distance if we move the school to the A.
Does everybody understand what is happening?
Ну, километр ни при чем.
Окей. Let me just...
So, do you follow what is happening or not?
Понятно, что происходит? But what is a bit confusing in your... Что было немножко непонятного? С одной стороны, вы считали про всех 100 студентов, говорили, что на 100 есть, на 100 километров. А с другой стороны, вы считали на одного. То есть на одного студента из А у нас имеется улучшение на один километр, а на одного студента из Б, ну если мы сдвигаемся на один километр или на Х, если мы сдвигаемся на Х, а на одного студента из Б у нас ухудшение на тот же самый Х. То есть если бы у нас было поровну студентов, скажем, по одному, то ничего бы все равно было бы здесь. А поскольку у нас это 100, то здесь у нас выигрыш будет 100х, а здесь будет 50х проигрыш. Соответственно, мы выиграем больше, чем проиграем, и поэтому есть прямой резон строить в А.
Окей. So, who thinks that he or she understands the solution and our English explanation? Okay, maybe you can repeat in English then. So it's too difficult. Okay.